In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning and welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. Today is the 25th Sunday in ordinary time. Today's gospel challenges us to do three things: put ourselves last, be the servant of all, welcome the least with limitless love. Are we ready to be servant to all? For the times we have failed, let us ask God for His mercy and pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever watching, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
To God. the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of the world. Amen, amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Let us lie in wait for the righteous man, because he is inconvenient to us and opposes our actions. He reproaches us for sins against the law and accuses us of sins against our training. Let us see if his words are true, and let us test what will happen at the end of his life. For if the righteous man is God's son, he will help him and will deliver him from the hand of his adversaries. Let us test him with insult and torture, that we may find out how gentle he is, and make trial of his forbearance. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to what he says, he will be protected. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let our response be, behold, the Lord is the upholder of my life. Kindly repeat.
Behold, the Lord is the upholder of my life.
O God, save me by your name, by your power. Defend my cause. O God, hear my prayer. Give ear to the words of my mouth. Your response.
Behold, the Lord is the upholder of my life.
For the proud have risen against me, and the ruthless seek my life. They have no regard for God. Our response.
Behold, the Lord is the upholder of my life.
See, I have God for my help. The Lord sustains my soul. I will sacrifice to you with willing heart and praise your name. For it is good. Our response.
Behold, the Lord is the upholder of my life.
A reading from the letter of Saint James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there will be disorder and every vile practice. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, open to reason, full of mercy and good fruits, impartial and sincere. And a harvest of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace. What causes quarrels and what causes fights among you? Is it not this, that your passions are at war within you? You desire and do not have. So you murder, you covet and cannot obtain. So you fight and quarrel. You do not have because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please kindly rise. God has called us through the gospel to obtain the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus and his disciples went on from the mountain and passed through Galilee. And he did not want anyone to know, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The Son of Man is going to be delivered into the hands of men, and they will kill him. And when he is killed, after 3 days, he will rise." But they did not understand the saying and were afraid to ask him. And they came to Capernaum. And when he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you discussing on the way?" But they kept silent, for on the way they had argued with one another about who was the greatest. And he sat down and called the 12. And he said to them, "If anyone would be first, he must be last of all and servant of all." And he took a child and put him in the midst of them, and taking him in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever receives one such child in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but him who sent me." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, there was an old monk staying in the monastery. He prayed many years for a vision from God to strengthen his faith, but it never came. He had almost given up hope. One day, as he was praying in his room, saw a vision appeared. The old monk was overjoyed, but then, right in the middle of the vision, the monastery bell rang. The ringing of the bell meant it was time to feed the poor who gathered daily at the monastery gate. It was the old monk's turn to feed them. If he failed to show up with food, the unfortunate people would live quietly, thinking the monastery had nothing to give to them that day. The old monk was confused between his earthly duty and his heavenly vision. But before the bell stopped ringing, the monk made his decision with a heavy heart. He turned his back on the vision and went off to feed the poor. Nearly an hour later, the old monk returned to his room. When he opened the door, he could hardly believe his eyes. There in the room, the vision was waiting for him. As the monk dropped to his knees in thanksgiving, the vision said to the monk, "My son, if you had not gone off to feed the poor, I would not have stayed. My son, if you had not gone off to feed the poor, I would not have stayed." My dear friends, the old monk learned that the best way to serve God is not necessarily to give up everything. It is not necessarily to turn our back on the world and go off to some monastery. It is not necessarily to spend hours in prayer contemplating heavenly visions. The best way to serve God is to do something far more basic. The best way to serve God is to reach out to your brothers and sisters, especially those who are poor, those who are sick, those who are struggling, especially in this pandemic. My dear friends, in today's gospel, we heard that the disciples were discussing and arguing with one another about who was the greatest. Jesus sat down and called the 12 and said, "If anyone would be first, he must be last of all and servant of all." Service was one of the most striking signs of Christ's own life. "I have come not to be served, but to serve." Jesus did not only preach, but he practiced in his life. My dear friends, all Christians are called to show the virtue of service. People who do not seek to serve God and their fellow human beings cannot be Christians. The very motto of Christian should be, "I serve." I think COVID pandemic is an opportunity for all of us to give an helping hand to poor and needy. Like Jesus, like old monk, let us go out of our way to serve the poor, those who are struggling, those who are suffering, especially in this pandemic. My dear friends, it is an invitation to all of us to look at our lives and ask ourselves, what is our own spirit of service in this pandemic times? It challenges us to take a few minutes off in the week and ask ourselves, how can we bring in this pandemic time a greater spirit of service that we now have? As we take part in this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask Jesus to give us the grace and strength so that we may put ourselves last and be the servant of all, especially poor and needy around us. Amen. Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Prayer of the Faithful. Even as Jesus makes the second prediction of the Passion, the disciples do not grasp the implications of what Jesus is communicating to them. Their thoughts are about themselves as to who is best among them. Jesus then teaches them a lesson in humility. Let us place our petitions before the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. Our response,
Lord, hear our prayer. For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that as leaders in the Church, they may not seek their own glory, but the welfare of the people of God. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Often we are engrossed in ourselves that we fail to see what is happening to people around us. That we may be attentive to the needs of others who may need our attention and time. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That thoughts of revengefulness and the desire to hurt those who have hurt us may be removed from our minds. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God grant us wisdom that is from above, which is pure, peaceable, open to reason, and full of mercy and good fruits, so that the decisions and the judgments we make may be beyond reproach. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that enlightened by the word of God, we may assume an attitude of simplicity, like that of a child, so that we may become people who can be trusted. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us spend a few moments in silence, praying for our personal intentions. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have this bread to give to you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Lutz, Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for the doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Is your life but trite and hollow? Do you seek a flag to follow?